Okay, as you can see, it's cold in here. I had some questions from Walter Macy, and he asked me how my setup was of my take lathe. Oops. Let's put the chair aside. I'm zoomed out. Yes. Okay. I can pull this forward. So. Okay, he asked me what the brand was of the 3-jaw chuck I use. So, let's zoom in. That's the brand. It is threaded for a take lathe. And when I wanted to order three new jaws, they wanted me to pay $200. So I refused. This is probably a very expensive chuck, or they wanted just to rip me off one way or the other. But I trued it with a stone from the inside in one of my videos. You can see that. Excuse my English, because I haven't spoken it in, well, I think 15 years at work, so it's kind of rusty, but doesn't matter. I hope you understand what I mean. These are the outer jaws, and the inner jaws are on it now, or the other way around. I don't know if it's the correct in English. Well, it's more of a junk box over here. I can't seem to keep it tidy. Underneath is a 3-jaw chuck from Take, but it's damaged. One of the previous owners had something in it and it flew out or something. I'm not exactly sure what happened. And he damaged it, so he probably replaced it with this chuck. And I like this chuck. See a little bit of rust over here. Not good. Okay. I also have one thing. This is the one I got from Walter. It has a metal ring, and the one I had was full aluminium. So that is too soft, and this is probably well, I'm sure it's an upgrade that Take did. I still have the old bottom plate, but I got this one from Walter. I'm very happy about it. Works much better than what I had. All kinds of things. Made this one for a slitting saw. Still have the one I made. Whoops. Back in place. Too much junk here. Okay. Still got this one. It's also seen in one of my videos I made, a fly cutter. More junk. I got a lot of stuff. I also see a bit of rust here. Must do something about that. It's very cold at the moment, so I don't spend a lot of time here at the moment. Well, just a normal chuck. It is set for Take. Not sure how big I can put in it. I think the hole through it is 16 millimeter, and if I'm correct, yes, it can all be also be on a plate, but doesn't need it, because in this setup it isn't needed. Made a few modifications to the take. As you can see, the bed, it's pretty worn, and it's an old, very old take lathe, and I think it's over 30 years old. And there are some things that are different from the newer models. As you can see, must clean it up someday. But one of the things is that this thing is on an angle, and the later models doesn't have that. So I can only guess how old it is. I contacted Nick Carter, and he said it's probably a very old one, one of the first. It was rebranded. It was branded Grimberg by a guy in Amsterdam. Let's see if I have. Oh, okay. Easy to use power. I made a rev counter, or install a rev counter. I got 2 speeds forward. And I can reverse it. But since it isn't locked, I would not advise to do that, because the chuck can come loose and you don't want to have that happen. Made a modification for this. I must say a previous owner did that. I made some modifications here. Installed a 13mm chuck is the correct name. Can't get some words I can't get in my head, because I haven't talked English in a long time. But I can also use the old 10mm chuck on it, of how you call it, also can do the 10mm on it instead of the 13. I got a lot of extras, homemade. I bought this bit and I had no holder for it, so I made it. This one is rarely used. Oops. Let me see. This I made it myself, because I couldn't get anything to fit it, so I had to make it myself. This one also made it myself, for round bars, when you want to make a hole in it exactly in the center, this comes in handy. I don't have a quick tool change post, so I got a lot of posts, some made by me, some are original. These are original, came from Nick Carter. These were made by someone else, they are steel, this is aluminium. This is the original tool post, so that's you can see the color is a bit different than this one. It's very old. Center with a spring, a few centers I made. And this is from a German lathe. It's metric, so you can use it on a take lathe. There were some questions about the vise I use. Can't say it is a very professional vise. Well, it's Proxon. Oops. Proxon. I made a little bit of modification on it, not sure, but it's an MS4. It fits. It isn't too accurate, but it does the job. You can see there is wobble here. So that means it isn't very accurate. Made an arrow, a bit of a ruler, so you could at least see something. Because it's fun to have something on here, but it has absolutely no use if you're going up and down a lot. So this works, so I'm happy with that. You wanted to know some measurements. Not sure what you wanted to know about the chuck. Let's see. It's all in millimeters. Let's see if I can get it. Zoom out a bit. Now, 40 millimeters, just about. I think it is 18 millimeters. Yes, the chuck itself is 80 millimeters. I don't think I have written down somewhere. Well, we'll put it in the description of the video. We'll find out. I think I have it somewhere written down. How big I can put in the chuck. Not sure right now. I don't know if you have any more questions. This is my little setup. And I'm happy with it. I made some changes. There's an electric power feed with also homemade. This is just some homemade stuff. I think I have some videos of it, how I made it. It's useful sometimes. Don't use it very often. Let's put it back in. Then a cheap 10 bucks ruler, a digital ruler. It works. It's not perfect, but okay, it will it will do for now. Maybe in the future I will buy an expensive one and put it behind the lathe. I'm not sure yet. Okay, that's for now. One little thing I made. Let's see. Yes. Okay. Just from a piece of metal. I had to do that. Because there wasn't anything commercially available. So if it isn't available, I make it myself, if possible, with the setup I have here. Don't have a huge lot of room or a huge shed, so everything is compact. All kinds of materials. Very hard these days to get nice materials. This is brass. Doesn't look like it, but it is brass. Someone gave it to me recently. I'm always happy if someone has an old piece of metal and they say, well, you can use it here. Because if I have to buy it, I have to pay a lot of money. It's absurd. Okay, Walter, if you have any questions, or any of the other viewers have any questions, just comment, like, or email me, and I will try to answer any questions.